Like we humans, even automobiles have a final resting place. Some will happily donate parts to extend the lives of others. Some, just a little damage, hope to find a new home. Well, for over 50 years, Stark Auto Sales in Toronto has provided this service to millions of vehicles. This week, though, Stark welcomes a very special visitor. Underneath that cover is Motoring TV's overall best vehicle for the year 2016. Before we reveal our winner, we take you to Detroit City, maybe not the Motor City of the past, but it's still home to what we and most of the automotive industry consider one of the most important shows of the year. It's called the North American International Auto Show. And along with bringing you some of the show's highlights, we have gathered to host our 1 hour Car of the Year special. Well, with me now, a guy I met in 1987 when I asked him, would you like to be part of a new automotive show on a new network, TSN? Well, the rest is history. Well, Graham, like we do every year, let's have a look at the class of 2016 and maybe how much it's changed since we first began.
Well, you know, if you go back to 1988, the range of cars ran from dreadful to very good. You fast forward to today, I drove a lot of cars last year, and you know, there wasn't a bad one amongst the bunch. The scale now runs pretty much from good to excellent, and it really is a very, very good time to purchase a car.
Well, over the next hour, we're going to have different segments with individual winners and then our overall winner, correct?
Yes, sir. What we do, we look at all of the different vehicles that are eligible for any given category. We pick the top three, then we pick the winner of that segment, and each winner of each category is then eligible for our Car of the Year.
All right, well, let's get things started with our first category. Now, for most of us, our budget dictates what we're going to buy. For others, not so.
Not so. Let's take a look at the nominees for Money No Object. BMW's i8 represents the future of the supercar. From its drop-dead good looks and scissor-style doors to the carbon fiber monocoque and hybrid powertrain, it's everything expected of future transportation. It not only delivers 24 kilometers of electric-only driving, it also brings 362 horsepower and 420 pound-feet of torque to the party. In the end, the i8 races to 100K in 4.4 seconds while sipping its precious fuel like a true hybrid miser. Where green usually means bland, well, the i8 is anything but. The AMG may have had big shoes to fill, but fill them it does. From the GTS's out there looks to the twin-turbo V8 that pumps out 503 horsepower and 479 pound-feet of torque, it's a ride that will set your heart a-pounding. It's also remarkably civilized, purring around town as easily as it piles on the speed. Now, the GTS runs to 100K in 3.8 seconds, and it does so while handling like the dickens. In the end, this car pushed all the right buttons for me. The Targa 4 GTS blends the best of the coupe and drop-top worlds in a single package, and it only takes one button to switch between personalities. Its sweet 3.8-litre flat-six dishes out 430 horsepower and 325 pound-feet of torque over a very broad range, meaning a run to the 100K in 4.3 seconds. However, the 911's forte has long been the manner in which it races through a corner. The Targa is no different, as everything works together in a very rare harmony.
Three fantastic vehicles, but our winner is...
the AMG GT. I mean, it really does put a fire in your belly when you drive it. I love that car. However, I also like the i8 because it does represent the future of the sports car. 911 Targa, what more can you say?
It all looked good in my driveway. All right, we just got started. Still to come, we reveal our overall best vehicle for 2016 as our 1 hour Car of the Year special continues from the North American International Auto Show.
Yes, I'm still wearing my tux. To me, some traditions are sacred. But you know, what isn't here at the Detroit Auto Show is almost as interesting as what is. Jaguar, Land Rover, Mini, Bentley, Tesla, they all decided to give Detroit a pass. Either they didn't have anything all that new to show, or they just felt they had better ways to spend their scarce marketing dollars. Now, is this a warning sign? Are auto shows as we know them on their way out? After all, everything that was revealed here was already seen on the internet weeks ago. But you know, over the next couple of weeks, hundreds of thousands of people are going to troop through this hall, metaphorically and literally kicking the tires on their next ride. So I think auto shows will be around for a while yet.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very proud to present the stunning Buick Avista Concept.
Motoring TV is brought to you in part by Stark Auto Sales, a better way to buy a car.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce the new Genesis G90.
Motoring TV's overall best vehicle for the year 2016 is under that cover at Stark Auto Sales in Toronto. But we're here at Cobo Hall in Detroit, site of the North American International Auto Show. And here's Graham with our next category.
Most shoppers start at the entry level. With that in mind, let's take a look at the best new small car. When the Honda Civic was introduced in 1973, only 747 cars were sold that year. Time has seen the sales of this class-leading compact grow to the point where it's been Canada's favourite car for as long as I can remember. The reason is not difficult to understand. It can be just about anything to any customer. From affordable sedan, sporty coupe to the SI models and a hybrid, it has the bases covered. While the Scion iM is based on the Toyota Corolla, it brings a splash of dash, it has much tidier handling, and it delivers a comfortable ride without feeling disconnected. Likewise, it arrives with a lot of content and two of the best seats in the industry. If there is a hitch, it is that it just does not engage the driver in quite the same manner as its peers. In spite of Volkswagen's diesel woes, the Jetta still represents an attractive alternative to the usual suspects in the small car category. It has style and it drives as only a European car can. It's pointed and focused. Better yet, the old engine has made way for a sweet 1.4-litre turbocharged 4. This move alone drags the Jetta from the past and very much into the present. Factor in the refined interior and its available content, and the Jetta is a very strong contender.
I think I know who the winner is, Graham, but it took them a few tries to get it right.
Absolutely. I mean, it wasn't very well received when it was reworked in 2012. They had to do it again in 13, and now comes the 16. The Civic is our best new small car, and it's been that way, you know, as Jim Kenzie said, for an ice age.
Well, you know, as we all know, crossovers are now the meat and potatoes for the automotive industry. In fact, they're so popular, we have not one, not two, but three crossover categories. Let's begin with affordable crossover.
What goes unspoken about the 2016 Jeep Renegade is the fact that it's based on the Fiat 500X. Now, that's not such a bad thing, as the company has done a very good job of putting some serious separation between the two models. While the base models are really designed for on-road use, the Trailhawk arrives with the equipment needed to make the Renegade a true Jeep. The Select Train Traction Management System includes a rock mode and 20-to-1 crawl ratio, which gives it some mustard in the boonies. Honda's HR-V is a city-friendly crossover with more than its fair share of comfort, convenience and versatility. With the seats upright, it delivers 657 litres of space and 1583 when folded down. When lowered, the floor is flat and the area is nicely squared off, so just about all of the space is functional. It's powered by a 1.8-litre 4 that's married to a CVT. In a move for the better, the CVT actually works without being a pain in the ear. As a package, well, it's one to be reckoned with. With the popularity of the compact crossover growing, the timing of the CX-3 was right on the money. It's an attractive ride that brings flexibility in an urban-friendly package. As with the rest of Mazda's lineup, it does not have to take a back seat to any of its peers. From the look to the handling, it has an impishness to its personality that's very difficult to ignore. It also arrives with a full suite of Mazda's SkyActiv technology. Everything from the chassis and suspension to the powertrain and all-wheel drive. Motoring TV's best new affordable crossover is the Mazda CX-3.
The buzz phrase, if you like, at the Detroit show is autonomous driving. Every manufacturer is showing technology that is leading to the self-driving car. Now, personally, I think it's at least 5 years before there's a fully autonomous automobile available to the general public, and maybe 10 or 15 years before they take a big share of the market. There are logistics and, frankly, technical issues that still have to be dealt with, not to mention the legal issues. And these things are going to be expensive, so I think it's going to be a while before the general public accepts it. Now, personally, I'd rather drive, but I see an awful lot of people out there who probably should let the car do the driving for them. And autonomous advocates say these cars will be much safer because most crashes are caused by human error. But even myself, driving on the 401 to oblivion down here to Detroit, I was thinking, geez, maybe it wouldn't be such a bad idea if I could take a nap in the backseat, having just said to the car, take me to Detroit. But you know, Dr. Porsche once said that when we find better ways to move people and stuff around, some people will still want to drive because they love to drive. It's kind of like horses. Unless you're Amish, in which case you're not watching this show, nobody takes their horse to work anymore, but some people love to ride their horses just because it's fun. So maybe 20 years from now, there'll be me and my Miata driving around Mosport having the time of my life.
This is the future of the Chrysler brand. This is the 2017 Chrysler Pacifica.
Still to come, we reveal our best overall vehicle for 2016 as Motoring TV's 1 hour Car of the Year special continues on TSN.
This 3-liter V6 is what differentiates the 1992 Tempo from previous years. Prior to this, only a 4-banger was available. Now the knock against that is that the immediate competition has been the Chevy Cavalier, which is always offered a V6. This new 3-litre sequentially multi-port fueling...
Sorry.
Digital dashboards, for example, were popular a few years ago, but drivers with bifocals found they couldn't focus on the instrumentation. We're starting to see larger...
Now, if you want to extend the life of your automatic transmission, and if you're aware of the price of rebuilding one today, you may be very interested in this. It's important... No, not important. You knew.
Anyway, now to the scoreboard for a rundown on the 1992. I forgot what the car was.
Motoring TV is brought to you in part by Salty Racer, the high-performance salt and stain remover. Available at Canadian Tire and Parts Source.
At Stark Auto Sales in Toronto, our overall best vehicle for 2016 patiently waits. While here in Detroit at the North American International Auto Show, we continue with our 1 hour Car of the Year special. Let's join Graham for our next category.
The need to clean up our environmental act is pressing. With that in mind, let's take a look at the nominees for Best New Green Car. Sustainable mobility is a buzz phrase that's not going to go away anytime soon. BMW's take is found in the i3. At the heart of this electric conveyance is a carbon fiber chassis and an electric motor that produces 170 horsepower and 180 pound-feet of torque. This sees it run from rest to 100K in 7.3 seconds. It also boasts an electric-only driving range of up to 160K. Now, if that's not quite enough to meet your needs, the range extended version adds another 100K to the drive. The first Chevrolet Volt hinted at what happens when an electric car is given a gasoline-powered boost. It effectively eliminated range anxiety. The second generation takes the basic idea and transforms it into an eminently drivable car that boasts an electric-only driving range of 85 kilometers and an extended range of up to 676K. During the test, the Volt delivered its power while consuming an average of 3.7 liters per 100 kilometers. Any way you cut the cake, that is exceptional. Normally, one would not view a full-size sport ute as a green car. The Volvo XC90 T8 twin-engine plug-in hybrid more than fits the bill. First, the gasoline engine uses both a supercharger and a turbocharger to improve efficiency. Add two electric motors, a 9.2 kilowatt-hour lithium-ion battery, and you have a net system output of 407 horsepower. The combination delivers a run to 100K of 5.9 seconds and a claimed fuel economy rating of 2.1 liters per 100 kilometers. That, by any measure, is stellar performance.
And our winner is...
the Chevrolet Volt. You know, I wasn't much of a fan of the original Volt, but the second time around, they really have got it right. It rides and drives very nicely, and it comes without range anxiety.
Exactly. I mean, anybody can drop by when you're stranded with a gallon of gasoline, but not a gallon of electrons. All right, now we're going to switch from the warm and fuzzy to what really North Americans want if sales figures back that up, and they do. It's the number one seller in North America, and that's a pickup truck, and they want all the bells and whistles, and they're willing to pay for it. Well, our truck guy, of course, is Howard Elmer. He's standing by to have a look at the year of pickups as well as his winner for 2016. Howard?
For the truck of the year, we have to look back at last year as the beginning of a trend that saw the aluminum-bodied F-150 making such a splash that everyone looked at it and said, this is going to wipe out all the awards. Yet GM jumped back into the mid-size category and brought out something that people were saying was right-sized, something that I agreed with. And in fact, sales have proven that. Now this year, to up that game, they've put in a 2.8-liter diesel engine. This is a first in North America, and yet in the rest of the world, it's old hat. And frankly, that's what makes this truck so interesting. It now puts us on that playing field with the rest of the world. So for 2016, Chevy Colorado and the GMC Canyon are our pick for truck of the year.
So what's a Georgia Viaduct? Well, it ain't a Groucho Marx movie, I can tell you that much. I'm Ted Laternis, and I'll tell you exactly what it is on MotoringTV.com.
We'll be back as our one-hour Car of the Year special continues from the North American International Auto Show on TSN. Stay with us.
Ladies and gentlemen, the all-new Infiniti Q60.
Ladies and gentlemen, here now on the stage and to the right and left here is the decidedly futuristic 2017 Forte and Forte 5-door.
Our overall top vehicle for the year 2016 is awaiting its moment at Stark Auto Sales in Toronto. But first, back here at the North American International Auto Show in Detroit, Graham Fletcher is standing by with our next category.
Next to money, no object, performance cars, well, they're always a lot of fun. Let's take a look at the nominees for 2016.
Of all of AMG's current range, the C63 is the epitome of everything the company holds dear. From its over-the-top looks and mellifluous exhaust note, it is a driver's car through and through. The precision of the drive and the unerring response to driver input aside, it's the 4-litre twin-turbo V8 that's the highlight. In S guise, it puts out a thundering 503 horsepower and 516 pound-feet of torque. This means it walks to the metric ton in 3.9 seconds. The Cadillac ATS is a good car in its own right. The ATS-V is something else altogether. It has more street presence with its athletic styling, a much more refined cabin that includes Recaro seats, and the ability to record a track session in real time. However, it's the mechanicals that give this car its overt appeal. From its magnetic ride suspension and twin-turbo V6 with 464 horsepower, right the way through to the 3.9-second run to 100 kilometers an hour, the ATS-V does not disappoint. Simply stated, it's a match for any German supercar. The Alfa Romeo 4C is a jaw-dropping ride that has a magnetic effect on all who cast an eye in its direction. The fetching cabin and supportive seats back up that initial promise. However, what makes the 4C is its mid-mounted 1.75-litre turbocharged 4. With 237 horsepower and 258 pound-feet of torque, 80% of which comes online at 1700 RPM, it blasts to 100k in 4.5 seconds. Throw in its prodigious handling and the fun of the drive does not get much better. Motoring TV's best new performance car is the ATS-V.
You know, Graham, maybe it's an age thing, but I find myself preferring four-door sedans to coupes. And what I like about performance category these days is that they do come with four doors.
Absolutely, they come with four doors. And the fact that they can carry and cater to the family does not detract from the way they perform. And that is certainly true of the Cadillac ATS-V. What a car.
And the renaissance of Cadillac continues. Now, our next category is a category that, at least in sales, is diminishing, but not in its importance.
No, absolutely it's not. Many people that shop for a car have got families. They need a sedan, so let's take a look at the nominees. While some would argue the changes to the latest ILX are subtle in nature, the reality is it ups its game and delivers a very credible entrant in a tough category. Now, this is particularly true of the A-spec model. Its 201 horsepower 2.4-litre four-cylinder is mated to an 8-speed twin-clutch transmission. This combination whisks it to 100k in 7.4 seconds. Throw in the A-spec's 225 40R18 tyres and it's a fun drive worthy of consideration. The latest Chevrolet Malibu is the result of a clean computer screen. As such, every facet has been visited and improved. Regardless of whether it's the new look, the quality evident in the cabin, or the athletic dynamics, it's sure to win fans in droves. The turbocharged engines also add some sizzle, and thanks to its diet, the Malibu feels lighter on its tires. The combination of attributes moves the Malibu from an also-ran to a real contender. There was not a lot wrong with the outgoing Kia Optima. The new model takes everything to a higher plane, especially the introduction of a new 1.6-litre turbocharged 4 that's married to a 7-speed twin-clutch transmission. With 195 pound-feet of torque at 1500 rpm and the right gear ratios, this version is as quick as it promises to be frugal. Throw in the high level of content and an artfully crafted cabin, and you have a car that's destined to be a hot commodity. When it comes to the family sedan category, we have a very rare occasion. We actually have a tie. I picked both the Malibu and the Optima. Both cars do everything exceptionally well. Both are very affordably priced for what you get, and they're also a lot of fun. You don't get much better than that.
One of the ironies of this year's show was that last week's Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas had almost as many automotive previews as this show did. Even the Chevrolet Bolt, which is being built in the Detroit area, was unveiled in Las Vegas, not in Detroit. Now, we've known for a long time that we're moving from cars with computers in them to computers with wheels on them. The merger of automotive and computer technology continues apace. Now, maybe we'll know for sure that those two have merged completely when Apple reveals the iPhone 8 at next year's Detroit Auto Show.
Our overall best vehicle for 2016 has some pretty nice company back at Stark Auto Sales in Toronto. And we'll find out what is under that cover shortly as we continue with our Motoring TV 1 hour Car of the Year special on TSN.
Well, in a two-minute test drive, what we try to do is entertain it firstly, and then give you a little bit of information to go along with that. That's why there's such a wide variety of vehicles. It's not always new cars, it can be old cars. In fact, we even have one that's only loosely a car this year. Hey, buddy, another album coming out?
Not yet.
The other great thing about 2 Minute Test Drive this year, for the second year in a row, we won the Automotive Journalists Association of Canada Best Broadcast Video. It's not me, it's the whole team. So thanks for that, and we'll see you next season.
Everything that's great about our new sedan and makes it even more sporty. It also takes Chevrolet into a new segment to further expand our portfolio here in the US.
Well, that is it. It's been fun. So for Jim Kenzie and Graham Fletcher, I'm Brad Diamond. We'll see you next week for more stories and a lot more cars on Motoring 91. Jim, the next time you wear tux, don't wear the blue pants with it.
Hey, and short notice, embarrassing. Short notice is the best I could do. And besides, I really like your shoes. They really go well with the outfit.
Well, you can always count on me for the class.
What a guy. What a guy.
One that's really, really tough.
Motoring TV Closed Captioning is brought to you by Chevrolet. Find new roads.
So, ladies and gentlemen, introducing the 2017 GMC Acadia.
We're back at the North American International Auto Show in Detroit, the site of our one-hour Car of the Year special. Let's now join Graham with our next category.
Our next two categories are both showing enormous sales increases. Let's take a look at the nominees for Crossover and Best New Luxury Crossover. The reworked BMW X1 delivers a spacious cabin that's packed with quality materials and a ton of practicality. As is to be expected, it carves a corner better than most with its millimeter precise steering and compliant suspension. It does a good job of controlling body motion while soaking up the rough stuff. The smooth 2-litre 4 fires 228 horsepower and 258 pound-feet of torque through an 8-speed automatic transmission and all four wheels. In the end, the X1 is a driver's crossover. Kia Sorento has been redesigned more often than any of its peers. The result is more refinement and better luxury with each reworked model. The current crossover arrives with a choice of engines, a good all-wheel drive system, and a compliant suspension that keeps things on an even keel. Inside, it's wrapped in top-notch materials and brings all of the mod cons. There's also seating for up to seven. As a package, the latest Sorento is complete. While the Land Rover Discovery Sport resembles its larger, more luxurious siblings, it arrives with a lighter, leaner driving feel. Part of its attraction is found in the 9-speed automatic and the 2-litre turbocharged 4-cylinder that twists out 240 horsepower and 250 pound-feet of torque. The rest of it lies in the Disco's multi-mode terrain response system and assorted suspension that's equally happy on and off-road. The combination delivers an attractive go-anywhere ride. Motoring TV's best new crossover for 2016 is the Kia Sorento. A new look and a new name bring Benz's largest SUV in line with the rest of its expanding portfolio. It's a big, bold, and luxurious full-size crossover that delivers more than its fair share of technology. One surprising aspect is how light and light the GLS feels on its 22-inch tires. This is, after all, a seven-seater that has a cavernous 2,300 liters of space when the seats are folded flat. It also offers a diesel engine, twin-turbo V6 and V8 engines, along with the mighty GLS 63. The Cayenne SE Hybrid puts a different spin on the typical full-bodied crossover. The 3-litre V6 engine, 8-speed transmission and electric motor combine to deliver a net system output of 416 horsepower and 435 pound-feet of torque. Firing that lot through an advanced all-wheel drive system brings a run to 100k of 5.9 seconds. On the flip side, the 2,350 kilograms of Leatherline Luxury can be driven up to 36 kilometers using electric power alone. It speaks to the future and the need for cleaner air. All too often, a car that's billed as being all new really is not. Yes, most of it may have been tweaked or reworked, but seldom is it overhauled from bumper to bumper. The Volvo XC90 is the exception that makes the rule. Everything from the look to the platform and powertrain choices are totally new. The all four-cylinder drive e-engine lineup differs in that the 2-liter arrives with a supercharger for low-end punch and a turbocharger to boost the mid and top end. It all works to perfection. The winner of our best new luxury crossover is the Volvo XC90. Now, it's very interesting when you think about the fact that Volvo was basically bankrupt and in desperate need of cash. Well, they got it and they produced the right vehicle in the XC90. Very nice ride.
Our motoring tip of the week concerns the thumbs up and thumbs down on a lot of current and recent vehicles. The Ford F-150, big thumbs up for the aluminum body this year. The military grade aluminum body they replaced on the brand new F-150, saving them 550 to 700 pounds depending on the model on those pickup trucks. Better performance, better fuel economy, more nimble handling, just improves the whole operation of a vehicle when you can cut weight. Now I'm a Chevy pickup truck guy and I'd still buy a Chevy pickup truck for the powertrain, but you gotta take your hat off to Ford for that weight reduction. Everybody else is going to have to follow suit sooner or later. Can you imagine how much better the powertrain has to be on that vehicle that's 700 pounds heavier, equal the fuel economy? The other boys are going to follow suit. Now, thumbs down, Sprinter commercial vehicles. Great vehicle in terms of utility and performance of the vehicle, but the body just rusts terribly on those trucks. So if you're a tradesman like me or a plumber or electrician or whatever, you covet a vehicle like that for your work. You spend your hard-earned money on it, performs well, but it rusts out in nothing flat, and the rust on these vehicles is terrible. It doesn't even have to have a piece of trim or anything happening. They just rust everywhere. There's no excuse for a company with that engineering might to produce a vehicle like that in this day and age, so thumbs down for that. Now, thumbs up for the new Chevy Colorado and Canyon pickups. Great powertrain, great utility, great ergonomics. And they're great looking trucks too. They're actually pretty, which a lot of the full-size trucks these days, they're about as pretty as a brick. They look like they were designed with a framing square, but the Colorado and Canyon are really good looking trucks. Definite thumbs up. Thumbs down, vehicle manufacturers in general for not embracing all-weather tires. They're still producing vehicles for the Canadian market that come equipped with tires that are just not suitable for about 6 months of our year here in Canada. Now, if you're buying a vehicle like this, these high-end Audis and Aston Martin here, spending that kind of money, you're fully prepared that if you actually want to drive a vehicle like that in the winter, you're going to buy four wheels and four winter tires and do all that. No problem. It's going to cost you a lot of money, but that's quite okay. But when you buy a mainstream grocery getter or a minivan, it's got to come equipped with decent tires that'll give you performance for the winter time. And in most cases, they don't. You go out and spend $20,000, $30,000 on a brand new vehicle and you have to turn right around in many of these vehicles and buy four winter tires, four rims, TPMS sensors, the labor, HST. By the time the smoke clears on all that, you're way north of a grand that you've had to put into a vehicle you've already spent this huge amount of money on. It just doesn't make sense. Now, years ago, we didn't really have a choice, but now with all-weather tires, vehicle manufacturers could be equipping these vehicles with much better tires for the Canadian market that'll give performance all year round. And if you don't have good winter tires or all-weather tires on your vehicle ends up looking like that in pretty short order. That's your motoring tip of the week.
You know, one of the much anticipated launches here at the North American International Auto Show in Detroit was for a segment that has been in decline for many years. I mean, look at those numbers. No wonder many car companies simply got out of the business of building minivans. But at this show, Chrysler announced the end of the Town and Country, and it's being replaced with the Pacifica. And Graham, that is a nameplate they had before and that flopped big time.
Oh, absolutely, it flopped big time, and I hope it does better this time around. What I found very telling was the fact that they're going to build the Grand Caravan alongside the Pacifica in Windsor. Now, that is very telling because they're not going to sell, regardless of how good the Pacifica is, 50-plus thousand units, and they will not have the $21,000 Canadian special.
And, you know, we can't tell you about the new Pacifica, as obviously nobody's driven it yet, but if you're in the market for a minivan, you can't go wrong with either Honda, Toyota, or Kia. All right, we've got a lot more to come, including the announcement of our overall best vehicle for 2016 when our one-hour Car of the Year special continues from the North American International Auto Show in Detroit.
So let's look ahead at our aspirations and inspirations with the world debut of the Kia Telluride concept.
In just a few minutes from Stark Auto Sales in Toronto, our best overall vehicle for 2016 will be revealed. But first, back here on the floor of the North American International Auto Show, Graham has our next category.
It's time to take a look at the finer things in life and the nominees for our best new luxury car. The latest 7 Series is a technological marvel that takes a leaf out of the i8's playbook. It's a blend of carbon fiber, high-strength steel, and aluminum. The Diet puts more spring in its step when the 750's 445 horsepower blown V8 is under the hood. However, this car is really all about luxury. Everything from a nifty gesture control system to a first-class reclining right rear seat, infotainment screens galore, and a personal tablet that gives fast and easy access to a mind-boggling list of amenities. The S-Class is the technocrat of the Mercedes-Benz range. If the company offers it technology-wise, it's in this full-body car, right the way up to the S63 AMG Supercoupe. The S550 is powered by a 4.6-litre twin-turbo V8 that's good for 449 horsepower and 516 pound-feet of torque. The power reaches the road through a 7-speed transmission and all 4 wheels, which makes it an all-weather proposition. In the end, the S-Class Coupe is a seriously accomplished ride. The Lexus RC may only have 2 doors, but that makes it no less luxurious. It's marked by the interior craftsmanship, cabin quietness, and the manner in which it handles itself on a twisty road. It feels light and tight, the steering is precise, and the silky smooth powertrain drives all 4 wheels. Now, if enough is not quite enough, there's always the rear drive RCF. It brings more of everything, including a 467 horsepower V8 and an active torque vectoring system. Motoring TV's best new luxury car is the BMW 7 Series. Not only is it truly luxurious with all the amenities known to man, it's equally home romping through a series of S's.
You hear that noise? Right on cue, I love that. That's the Detroit People Mover. It's a bit ironic that what passes for mass transit in the city of Detroit runs right through the venue of the auto show. The fact remains that for North America, the mass transit system is the automobile. Yes, maybe we should all live in little rabbit warrens clustered into cities. We should stop building factories on our farmland. The fact is, we're not going to do that. The 401 highway across the top of the city of Toronto is the busiest highway in the world. We have come used to this. It's the way it is, and until somebody coughs up several billion dollars for infrastructure replacement, that's the way it's going to be. Yes, it would be lovely to be able to telecommute to work and maybe transport ourselves, Scotty, beam me to the office, but for the foreseeable future, a car is going to be in your future.
It's time for a little affordable fun and a look at the nominees for our best new sports car. The Audi S3 is the A3's evil twin. Everything that makes the mortal car such a delightful drive has been amped up, and it touches all of the driver's senses, including sound. The S3 has a very naughty exhaust note that actively urges the driver to drop a cog or two and enjoy the bassy cacophony. Now, a ferocious bark without a bite would be a drag. The S3's 2-litre turbocharged Ford delivers 300 horsepower and 280 pound-feet of torque at 1800 RPM, which is more than enough in a car that tips the scales at a svelte 1,430 kilograms. Completely redesigned, the latest Camaro fast-forwards Chevy's pony car into the here and now. In fact, only the tight rear sight lines link it to its predecessor. The handling is sharper without feeling twitchy, the response to driver input is now refined, and it has grip to spare. It also comes with three attractive engine choices: a strong turbocharged four-cylinder, a V6, and the 455 horsepower 6.2 litre V8. When so equipped, the Camaro blasts its way to 100k in 4 seconds flat. Ever since its introduction, the MX-5 has been without peer when it comes to the fun of the drive. It has the innate ability to transform a mundane drive into something to relish. The fact that car and driver become one means that you can drive the tires off it and it just seems to come back for more. Few cars balance the handling and powertrain quite as well. Now, if it's the size of the driver's smile that tells the story, the MX-5 story is a very good one.
Okay, we know what you're saying. If you're shopping for a Mazda, you're not shopping also for a Camaro or an Audi. Graham?
That's probably true, but you know, it's the glue that holds them together is the fact they're all sports cars. As for the winner, the Mazda MX-5, or Miata as I prefer to think of it. I really did like the original from back in 1990. This new car is everything it was, and so much more. It's as much fun as you can have while you're wearing jeans.
I remember 1990, it was the closest thing to an MGB I'd ever driven, and that's a good thing. And congratulations to Mazda for continuing to build a vehicle which really is niche. Okay, when we come back, the moment you've all been waiting for. We're gonna pull the wraps off our best overall vehicle for 2016 as our 1 hour Car of the Year show continues from the North American International Auto Show in Detroit.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the 2017 Chevrolet Bolt EV.
Did you know? Brought to you by the all-new 2016 Kia Optima, made for redefining performance.
Welcome to Fogo Island. Hi, my name is Aidan. The question is, how high had the license plate got me off the ground in my province of Newfoundland and Labrador? Go to motoringtv.com and enter our Did You Know challenge and a chance to win some cool stuff.
Well, it looks like the gang at Stark Auto Sales in Toronto are flipping a coin. I guess they want to see who's going to reveal our overall best vehicle for 2016. Now, as you know, all our category winners are eligible. So let's review the lineup. Graham is standing by with our winner, but first, as tradition dictates over the years, Jim Kenzie gets to tell us which car should be Car of the Year, despite what Graham and I decide.
Choosing a Car of the Year is always difficult, particularly so this year. Not that there's not a lot of good candidates, but to me there isn't one car that really stands out. Now, the two best cars I drove all year were the Cadillac ATS-V and the Mazda MX-5 Miata. But both of them are really sporty cars. They're niche models. They're almost toys. And to me, a Car of the Year should have larger market significance than that. Of the conventional passenger cars I drove, the two that really rose to the top for me were the beautiful new Chevrolet Malibu and the always capable Honda Civic. But you know, it's doubly ironic for someone like me to choose a Car of the Year that isn't a car. I mean, cars and trucks have been merging over the last decade or so. And to me, the overall vehicle of the year is the Volvo XC90.
Motoring TV's Car of the Year for 2016 is the Cadillac ATS-V. One look at the ATS and it's not difficult to tell it's related to the CTS sedan. Everything from the splitter to the rear diffuser says it means business. The V is powered by a 3.6-litre twin-turbo V6 that puts out stunning power. The 464 horsepower is good, but it's the 445 pound-feet of torque that grabs the driver's attention. Cadillac says the ATS-V arrives track-ready. On that, there is no argument from me. What is there to say about this ATS-V other than wow? Now, we consider them to be a family, so all models are eligible, but it was the ATS-V that pushed it over the top, and congratulations to Cadillac for building such a wonderful car.
We want to congratulate General Motors, the ATS, and all our winners. And we also want to thank our sponsors and you, our viewers, many of whom have been watching for almost 30 years. Without you, we wouldn't be on the air today. Before we go, make sure you check us out at motoringtv.com. You can see episodes you may have missed and also check out our broadcast schedule. And of course, join us on Facebook and Twitter for the total motoring experience. That's it for now. We'll see you next time out as we continue to bring you more stories about cars and the people who drive them.
The Toyota is a pretty straight, button-down kind of company. They make great vehicles, but with little glitz. So you can imagine the raised eyebrows at this morning's technical briefing when the Tacoma chief engineer described his new truck as badass.